Lived in a lot of places. I've lived in Inglewood, California. Anybody else here from Inglewood? Really? We got one? Nice. You're like the first one to probably not mean it at all. Nobody means it. They just cheer. I live there for reals. It's a pretty great neighborhood. It's up to no good if you've listened to the music. Inglewood, up to no good. And that's a rapper saying it's up to no good. That's not your mom, like, stepping out of the car going, this neighborhood seems iffy. It's a rapper going, don't live here. And I was like, I'm going to. Like, I like it here. But it's great to live in, like, a relatively shitty neighborhood. Like, I loved living there. I had no money. And you can still have fun with no money, especially in kind of a bad neighborhood, because you can play fun games that you make up yourself. Like, I made up a fun game. I called it Match the Apartment with the Wandering Infant. That was fun. That's really fun. I think that's what they mean by if you love something, let it go, right? Just... let it go down the stoop, down the block. I used to like lie about how nice my neighborhood was. I'd be giving people directions to my apartment. I'd be like, oh yeah, and if you can't find a spot on the street, just park behind the check cashing store and run. But don't run like you're scared. Run like you're jogging. Because they smell fear. They're like bees with cornrows. That is not a racist statement. I think we all know that white people can have cornrows. And I personally would be much more afraid of a white guy in cornrows than a black guy in cornrows. Right? Because a white guy in cornrows is basically looking right at you and saying, hey, I don't know the difference between right and wrong. I did this to myself.